You can really boil down what's happening in the Middle East to something relatively simple, and that is that the Muslim world does not want to be occupied by the U.S. military, and they will not stop resisting until the U.S. military leaves,
and
it will leave.
If you had been Obama, would you have not acted with those videos of beheadings by people claiming to represent
the Islamic State on the television? But we have to understand that that was a reaction. You know, we've been brutalizing these people for over a decade, and we have decapitated through our drones, our aircraft, our missiles, far more people, including children, than ISIS has ever decapitated. And when you brutalize people to that extent, they become brutal. You see that eruption of brutality, but you don't see all the times they stood over the rubble of homes and saw the bodies of women and children and elderly over and over, day after day. And that's the failure, the inability to understand the consequences of indiscriminate violence and what it does to a captive population. So if you don't have an air force, then you have a symbol of imperial superpower in the form of a captured journalist like Foley and a knife. But there is no moral difference between a beheading by ISIS and a drone strike by America.
And in terms of U.S. reactions, was there an alternative?
Well, the sane reaction is to get the hell out of there and stop occupying their countries and stop, you know, these drones circle 24 hours a day. It's 24 hours a day of terror because you know at some point somebody's, you know, some wedding party or something is going to get blasted to smithereens. What any state at war seeks to do is paint those who oppose them as barbarians, as uncivilized, as animals. Without understanding that if we were in that position, many of us would not react any differently. And I actually wrote a column about this called How the Brutalized Become Brutal. And I went back to the Sobibor uprising, where Jewish inmates who had had their families wiped out got knives and went into the office where the Germans were and said, this is for my mother, this is for my father, this is for my children, this is for all the... It is a very human reaction. I quoted J. Glenn Gray in his great book, Warriors: Reflections on Men in Battle, who talked about, he fought in World War II, about soldiers whose families were destroyed. And he said it wasn't about revenge. It was about the utter annihilation of the enemy. And that is what we're seeing in ISIS. What we don't see is that we caused it.